Welcome to the Whaler Guys at our world headquarters at 2028 Sergeant Street in Hartford. Danny's behind the board tonight, and Gil Martinez is in the house. We want to say hi to Gil and
station manager.
Happy New Year to everybody. It's, you know, Peter had a show last week. I was absent. Mm-hmm. I was out on assignment.
Yeah.
Hitting the bricks, finding Whaler fans underneath the rocks, and trying to pull them out so we have a little more Whaler Brigade people out there.
Right.
We hope everyone is enjoying the new year. We're really excited. We have a lot going on. Mm-hmm. Pete, what's up with you?
Not too much. You know, after the holidays, you know, things got kind of quiet, you know, with the NHL-wise in Hartford. We weren't really hearing too much. And we did get a little nervous just before the holiday break, about early December. You know, the Florida Panthers got all wrapped up into a new deal in their current location. They gave the city land. They gave the city the option. They're going to, if they were ever to leave, they would have to pay back the city the money that they're owed. So, you know, it looked like that was bad for Hartford because another team was off the block. But we are hearing good things. We are hearing that the NHL is still visiting Hartford for whatever reason. Maybe we don't know, but we're hearing that, and we're hearing that from more than one place. You know, we just had an incredible evening at UConn. They had a Whaler night at UConn. Great event. What did you think of that?
Well, you know, I think it's interesting. You know, we talk about coincidences yeah. and why we stay in the game and why we keep on doing what we do. Because, you know, Friday night was an 8:30 start.
Yep.
It's against Vermont. It's the first nationally televised game on NESN.
Yeah, in Hartford.
And they drew 6,500 people.
Yep.
For a team that's not playing at its best these days,
no.
with injuries,
right.
and we have to put that all into perspective.
Sure.
They drew 6,500 people. There was people in the Whalers gear, jerseys, hats. Yeah. I saw a friend of mine I haven't seen in almost 20 years, and his father, who were season ticket holders. And I've talked to you about seeing the Russians play the New England Whalers at the Hartford Civic Center
right.
back in 1976. That was my friend and his father, whose season tickets I was able to sit only about four rows from the ice, watching the Russians, the best team in the world, play the New England Whalers, and pleasantly surprised that the New England Whalers beat them 5-2 that day.
Right, and you know, there was a story about the New England Whalers were going through the flu, the locker room, so they didn't even have their full starting lineup when they won that game. But you know, talking about the UConn Whaler night, that was the largest Friday night hockey crowd yet this year. And that's what made it special, because you're absolutely right. UConn is just... This hockey season.
Not
right.
this year.
No, no, no. Yeah, this hockey season.
We're
going to make that clarify.
28 days.
Yeah, that's right. So, yeah, the point about that is, you know, to get that good of a crowd when UConn is not playing well at all. They, you know, they kind of let us down against Vermont. They got shelled by Sacred Heart last Tuesday. They're just not playing as well as they were last season. But, you know, the attendance has not really dropped off that far. And we talked about that, how the attendance... because we talked to Channel 8. The Sports Edge were there, and you know, we got a chance to talk to them and let them know about what we're doing. We talked about our Whaler Brigade and the TV show, and we also talked about how, you know, UConn 2 years ago or 3 years ago, when the governor said that, you know, if you want the NHL, go see UConn, and we thought, boy, that sounds absolutely nuts. I mean, nobody's going to come to see college hockey, but since they joined Hockey East, we've been pleasantly surprised at the amount of people that show up at these games. You know, last year, 11 games, 64,000, and that was 40% of what the Wolfpack drew in 38 games. Mm-hmm. So just to give you perspective about how much UConn has been drawing, and you thought, like, it's a lower level of hockey, but yet people are coming out.
Well, you know, it's interesting. You say a lower level of hockey,
yeah.
and I think you can put UConn, mm-hmm. As much as they are not professionals, the Wolfpack is a professional hockey club.
Right.
Let's not pull... no strings here. It is a professional hockey club. It is developmental hockey to get them ready for the NHL.
Mm-hmm.
And but when you put 6,500 people in a building for a Friday night game at 8:30, and the Wolfpack isn't drawing quite as much, it really, when you look at it, you can parallel it as professional hockey.
Yeah.
That's what it seems like the fans are attributing it to.
Right,
that
right.
It is for them professional hockey. What amazes me is, like you said, the team's not playing well, there's injuries, they're falling off down the standings, but the people keep coming back.
Yeah.
I find that baffling, because Connecticut fans are fickle fans.
Yeah.
Now, for them to come and 6,500 people show up, mm-hmm. Whether it was Whaler night or because it was a Friday night, There was a lot of people there. And so I'm really happy that the fans continue to support UConn.
Right.
6,500 people for a team that's not doing well.
And not doing well.
Gave up
yeah.
two really soft goals
yeah.
to end the game.
Right.
Was really disappointing.
Yeah, and not only that, but we're talking about a building that it really is, it's not the greatest building in the world. So, to get 6,500 into that building, we're not trying to say that that's justification for an NHL crowd. But the point about the lower level of hockey, it may be that, but it's UConn is on a national stage with Hockey East. That's something
yes.
they have over the Wolfpack. The Wolfpack minor league hockey doesn't get a lot of play in the
it's
current.
More regional.
Doesn't get play in the current. Doesn't get play on. It's hard to get the games on the radio sometimes. That plays into a factor sometimes of drawing people in. Once UConn got into Hockey East and became a national product, you saw all this interest, which really surprised, because if you remember 3 years ago, UConn played an afternoon game against the Air Force, and only like 1,200 to 1,400 people showed up. And mm-hmm. I thought, boy, this UConn thing, I don't think that's really going to take off. But it has absolutely done that. And, I was completely wrong about that.
And we just did a podcast before we came into the TV station. And really, we talked about the marketing of hockey in Hartford.
Mm-hmm.
UConn.
Mm-hmm.
The Hartford Current has bought into the UConn publicity. I don't know what they're doing. I don't know if UConn is paying them, or I don't know what they're doing. But you know what? If the Wolfpack got the coverage that UConn hockey and UConn basketball, it would be different.
Yeah.
And we have to start pushing, whether it's the state, or Spectra, the Hartford Current, put the Hartford Wolfpack on the front page once in a while, because it's hockey season. Yes, UConn basketball is playing, but there's a big page. Put UConn up top, put the Wolfpack down below.
Yeah.
Put them on the front page. You have to market this team, or they're just not going to draw. And it's not fair for the Hartford Wolfpack to not be marketed the way they were back when they first got here.
Yeah.
I said it before when we were out doing the podcast. We have to market the hockey club we have. If the NHL comes and the Wolfpack goes away, that's one thing.
Yeah.
But they're here.
Yeah.
They are Hartford's hockey team, whether people like it or not.
I know.
And, I'm not a big Ranger fan, but you know what? They're Hartford's hockey team right now, along with UConn.
Yeah.
And there has to be more marketing. And the sports reporters, like I said before, and I get all fired up all the time, have to embrace hockey in this city.
Yeah. And we went over it. People out there are so negative about the Wolfpack. I can tell you this. There just wasn't another team to come in. And MSG had, in their contract, they would have had to get another team to replace them. And they had to do that all by December 31st. They had to declare that they did not want to be in the XL Center. They didn't declare they did not want to be in the XL Center. And that's why we know that they're going to be here for another year.
Mm-hmm.
The point is that it wouldn't be good for Hartford to lose 38 dates at the XL Center and drawing 170,000 people, whether or not they're Rangers or whatever. The point is, it's good to have 170,000 people coming into your building when you're trying to get the NHL. It's good to have UConn in there. They're drawing a quarter of a million between the basketball and the women and men's and the ice hockey. So it's good to have events that may not be the team that you want to see, but it's good hockey. And right now, they've won 8 games in a row. Mm-hmm. Nobody knows about it.
Exactly.
8 games in a row. I don't think I can't remember.
Why is it on the front page?
It should
Hello?
Be. And, they play this weekend. And this weekend, this show, of course, will air after it. But this Saturday night, January 29th?
Mm-hmm.
30th.
30th.
Is Jeff Sanderson's going to show up at the Wolfpack game. So we expect a good Whaler crowd for Saturday night. And we also are glad that Jeff Sanderson showed up. He's going to drop the puck. He's going to do some autographs, that type of thing. We're also really looking forward to this license plate thing. We've had some meetings with a state representative. The license plate, we just want to put a thank you out to you guys. 600 signatures made the license plate a possibility, and now the legislature, it's on their radar.
And it's more of a possibility.
And it's thanks to you.
Yes, more of a possibility than ever before, because all we needed was 400. We have 600 signatures, and it's all you guys making this happen. That's what's important. It's not about us.
Yeah.
We're the voice. We're the pain in the neck out there making you guys remember the Whalers, keep the Whalers' name alive. But this is another step in keeping them now and in the future.
Yeah.
Hartford's hockey team.
Yeah.
And professional hockey team, major league hockey team.
Keep it on the radar, the license plate. I just want one.
Yeah.
We had people from Massachusetts saying, boy, we'd love to have a Whaler plate in Massachusetts. That was the greatest thing to ever hear. But, the greatest thing of all is these license plates probably will go to charity, a charitable organization.
Yes.
We haven't determined which one yet. But I don't care where it goes, because I just think it'd be great to do that for the city.
And the funny thing is, the hang-up, some of the hang-ups that, Kurt Vail is helping us out from, he's the representative from Stafford Springs and Summers. We've talked about him before. and Marie from the Legislative Office Building Legal Team is helping really move this along. The biggest hang-up is, and I think it's funny, they say, oh yeah, the Red Sox have a plate, the Yankees have a plate, because they also have teams.
Right.
The Whalers don't exist. I said, well, not really. They're somewhere else right now.
Yeah.
So it's funny when we get into that conversation that yes, we have to push it through the NHL, and that's going to be a longer process.
Right.
And that's not a bad thing. Let everything work together.
Right.
And we know that the trademark falls with the NHL. We also found out today that the Brass Bonanza is actually trademarked by the NHL. So it's interesting to see if they like the Whalers so much. Well, I think they're in Hartford for other reasons too,
right,
as we talked about before.
Yeah.
The other thing that you brought up, which is a very important thing, is those 38 dates.
Yeah.
38 dates bringing people in the XL Center, but it's 38 dates that the restaurants, the bars, and the businesses downtown are seeing people in their doors, and that's the most important thing as well. It's not just the hockey or the building. It's the downtown district making money so the city is sustainable and we can keep it going.
Mm.
And as we talked about, Michael Freemuth is going to get us into the XL Center. We're going to show you a behind-the-scenes look at the XL Center and why we need that money. There have been people out there that have been boo-hooing the idea of giving money to the XL Center. A couple representatives that don't live in the city but in the suburbs who maybe haven't been to the XL Center and really don't care about the XL Center. Well, if you don't care about it, why don't you go to a hockey game? Why don't you bring your kids to Disney on Ice? You know what? It's the nucleus of downtown. And if you don't want to do it, stay away.
Yeah.
But there's a vested interest for the XL Center by all of us.
Right.
It's our obligation to keep the XL Center up and running.
Yeah, I mean, we see so much of the suburbanite shots at Hartford. And, you know, my concern is if you're not going to the XL Center, you haven't been in years, or you don't go to events, or you don't go in the city because of whatever reason, you believe the parking, whatever the reason, you really can't say much about the XL Center and change my mind. I mean, we know it. We're the guys that know a lot more about this stuff than other people. Don't say that the humble brag. I say that because I just don't see anyone else talking about the things we're talking about that we know from talking with the state and talking to the XL Center, talking to the Spectra, talking, you know, you have to get out there and speak to these people because the XL Center is in dire straits. It really needs a lot of work. Now, you go in there and you look at it and it looks fine, but everything's behind the scenes, the wiring, the mechanics, the ice making, it's not up to date. And if it doesn't get up to date, then, you know, Hartford's going to become a 9-to-5 city forever. It really is. I mean, it's a central entertainment piece. Like I was saying earlier, we don't go out there and poo-poo the Bushnell or the Hartford Orchestra or anytime they have difficulties because we're not attached to them. But we want everything in Hartford to excel, all of it, all around.
But remember, the Bushnell did a major remodel some years ago.
Right.
Hartford Stage just did a major remodel.
Right.
The XL Center is the obvious next choice to keep in downtown Hartford.
Right.
Those three things alone mm-hmm. are keeping people in the city.
Yeah.
In the entertainment side of things. Mm-hmm. Then you have your restaurants that surround and take advantage of those people coming downtown.
Yeah.
So, you know, for people to say we're not putting money in XL Center, they need to stop it. They need to go away and they have other agendas, I'm sure, they can focus on. We'll focus on making the city more profitable by bringing people from the suburbs downtown. And now with Connecticut Transit and Fast Track doing very well.
Yeah, they are.
It's another reason to support Fast Track.
Yeah.
We talked about it. People are taking, we talked to a guy the other night, him and his girlfriend, or fiance, are coming downtown to see the hockey games. And they live out in the Newington, West Hartford area.
Yeah.
So they're taking that bus down mm-hmm. to the hockey game and taking it back.
Yep.
They have no complaints.
Right.
They get dropped off right in the front of the XL Center to go see the hockey game.
Yeah, and a lot of people, you know, on the busway, I understood a lot of people were upset, and they thought, oh, it's a busway to nowhere, this and that, blah, blah, blah. You work with Central, you know that busway is busy. It's getting peaked.
93,000 rides by CCSU
over
students
the summer, right?
Since it's opened.
Yeah.
And we gave away 1,000 more passes that Central had to pay for to the students so they will come downtown. We know that they added more buses on certain nights to go downtown to the bars and have a good time. They added buses to bring them home at 1 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's working for the New Britain area.
Yeah.
For the new, and we're on the board of New Britain and Newington.
Right.
So, you know, you're going to go where this bus goes.
Right. And, you know, I as a person that takes the bus kind of regularly because I live not too far from Hartford, there wasn't a bus after 8:30. You had to, you know, there needed to be a later bus schedule because part of the 9 to 5, you know, thing with Hartford, everyone leaving after 5 o'clock, the buses stopped running after, you know, a certain 7:30, 8 o'clock. So you needed that public transportation piece to, you know, keep the city revitalized at night. And the XL Center is such a key piece in that. And we've talked about the numbers about how, you know, they're drawing over, you know, 300 to 400,000 for hockey with the Wolfpack, with UConn basketball, with women's basketball. Mm-hmm. That's just sports alone. You add in the concerts and all, Disney on Ice and all that. You cannot lose this piece in Hartford and have it be a successful city, as far as I'm concerned.
No, not at all. And when you get down there on a night where UConn's playing, or the Wolfpack, when they have a large crowd of 6,000 to 7,000 people, the city is abuzz.
Yeah.
And it's fun to be down there. Mm-hmm. It's contagious. You want to be part of that. You want to be a Hartfordite.
Yeah.
You know, Dennis House has talked all the time about the energy in Hartford,
right,
about what he's enjoyed in Hartford. He'll take snapshots and he'll put them on his Facebook page, or he'll put them on his website, Hartfordite.
Yeah.
You know, it's what we bring to the city.
Right.
You know, people talk about crime. Crime stays in certain parts of the city.
Right.
It does not affect the downtown district. Mm-hmm. It does to a certain degree, but you know what? Hartford PD does a great job downtown.
Mm-hmm.
I've talked to the Hartford cops. I've talked to them about what's going on downtown. And you know, it's great because they like the energy. When there's a busy night, they get excited. When they have to work their jobs, their private jobs, whether it's in the XL Center or the traffic outside, they enjoy the bustle of the crowd.
Right.
It brings back the days of old when Hartford was a really vibrant city.
Right, right. Yeah, and that's what we talked about is the NHL put Hartford on that national stage. UConn's kind of doing that a little bit with the Hockey East. Of course, they're not playing that well. That doesn't help. But, you know, that national recognition makes it a whole different city.
Okay.
And you know, there was a thing in The Current that we talked about in the podcast about an op-ed piece where a guy from Avon said that, you know, he was talking about, he was up in Montreal, he was at a bar, and the barkeep said, you know, don't you guys want the Whalers back? And he was kind of like, well, let's not be Boston or New York. Let's just be Hartford. Let's be mediocre. Let's just be average. Let's just be, you know, that kind of thing. And the bartender asked him twice, don't you guys want the Whalers back? So if someone so far out of our city has this, you know, optimistic view of us, why should we push out the pessimistic view? You know, so I did not agree with the guy at all.
And that's really what bothers me is, yes, New York is a great city.
Yeah.
Boston's a great city.
Yeah.
And you know what? We are our own city.
Yeah.
When are people going to wake up and stick up for our city?
Yeah.
And say, no, Hartford has so much to offer. You just did a show last week with a guy who brought all kinds of
interesting
history about our city.
Yeah.
Has anyone taken time to realize what we have?
Yeah.
You know, yeah, we talked about the Bushnell, Hartford Stage, the XL Center. Well, what about the Mark Twain House and other things in Hartford? That's the most important thing people have to realize. Yeah, my kids are older now, but I took them all over the place.
Yeah.
I mean, we had in West Hartford, we had the Children's Museum. Now you have the Connecticut Science Center. It's a great place. Matt Fleury does a great job downtown. And, you know, we go to the Green Gala every year and have a great time seeing the people of Hartford coming to support another great piece of Hartford.
Right, right. Yeah.
And it brings all those kids downtown to give them an opportunity. For me, it was getting out of school because I hated school. These kids get a field trip to go downtown, and a lot of the money is raised are about getting kids downtown.
Yeah, actually, that's a huge part of it. You know, there's so many kids that go to the Wolfpack games, kids go to UConn games. You know, this helps with the, you know, in the suburbanite community, kids playing hockey in these rinks. You need to keep that up, and it's gone down, you know, since the Whalers left. So, but you know, we're almost out of time here again. Time goes by so quickly when we start ranting and raving about Hartford and how we want to make it a major league city again.
That's right. So we are going to catch you next time on the Whaler, guys. Remember, we are all one nation under green. You guys have a great night, and we'll check you next time.